What is up, guys? The XJ guy here, and welcome back to Spin Tire. And today, we're gonna have a look at three trail trucks. Those are not tow rig or anything. Those are specially made trail truck. They can't tow anything. They can't have trailer on it. They're just made for God on the trail. I'm gonna test each one of them and see which one is the best. Up first, we have the Spun 1972 Chevy K10. Then we have the 1997 Chevy K1500, and we have a 1999 GMC. I think it's a Silverado. Doesn't say anything on it, but look like a Silverado. So up first, it's the K10. Look what we got as far as the option goes. And I think it's on the back. We have a spare tire, Isle of Jack, and some fuel canister. Gotta have a canoe. And we have like a hard top. So gonna go with the supplies. And we have the default tire. Look like BFG KM2. Got DSL Thornbird. And we have Pitbull Rocker. And I gotta admit, my favorite are always the Pitbull Rocker. But for once, the Thornbirds look good on it. And let's match the spare tire. So let's go with the Thornbird. Let's see what this thing can do. I'm gonna run my usual trail test. Let's see how this thing handles it. So far, riding pretty smooth. Not bouncing around everywhere. Not super fast, but not too slow. Just pleasant to drive. And those are three specially made trail trucks. So you not just have to perform well, you have to be fun to drive. So you have, like, for example, multiplayer fun with your friend. Go around the map, scouting the map and everything. So the truck can be fun to drive, not only overly capable rig, but just bounce everywhere and just simply not fun to drive. So at the start here, and let's take it in first and see if this thing can climb it. It's throwing pretty hard. Seems like we're making progress. Yeah, definitely not easy, but it made it, and that's the point. And the Thornbird looked good on this truck, but I don't know if they perform as poorly in Spin Tire as they do in real life. In real life, we used to call them turn shit. No, not turn shit, sorry. Thorn turd. That's what my friend called them. They're not good in real life. It's pretty much crappy TSL. Like, really crappy TSL. They wear unevenly. They wear way too fast, and they don't grip that good. So there's no really point on buying them. See if it can get out of the V-notch. It's always a tedious part of this little trail. Always the hardest part to go through. Let's see if I can find a line. more of an angle. Test the truck grip. If a truck can go up there, it's pretty good. Alright, I'm not gonna make it this way, so I'm gonna try to trick it a little bit. Always have more traction going up there. Let's try to crawl the front. Back in the same hole again. Damn it. This is really the hard part of this little testing trail. And oh damn it, I flip it. So I was not gonna make it anyway. So I'm gonna rescue it to the garage to not be in the way of the other one. And I'm gonna go on with a Chevy 97. So as far as modifications go, there's nothing. So I just take off. Let's see what this thing can do. I love the mod made by CCS, but I think I miss a little bit of details. I wish he just put like the third of the detail that Spahn did. Spahn really outdid himself with any trucks to do. Brute is pretty good too. CCS do quite a lot of mod. They work well, but they're missing a little bit of refinement. The detail are pretty much inexistent. The rough line out there, but I wish he had a little bit more. And I know this is quite a lot of work and nobody get actually paid for doing it. So I can understand that too. So let's get straight to it. And yeah, no problem. Yeah, I didn't forget to put it in first gear. Have to be fair, put it in first gear. The rocks here. It's kind of weird. There we go. Let's see if this thing get a bit more grip and the V-notch. Jeez, what the hell is that deformation? Large and light and able to go through. Really gonna have to find an alternative. All the last truck I test. That was a killer right there. thing actually, and able to get a grip on the side and work through. Alright, now it should be good to go. Not to the top. And this thing performed pretty well, but in my opinion, I think the suspension is a bit rough. Not smooth as I would like to be. But again, it's a truck, so I can't complain. But I would think the 1500 would be a bit more smooth, a bit more articulation. Oh, this dog is pretty fun to drive. And again, here we got a little problem. Let's see if we can get a grip. And up we go. Alright, that's pretty good. A decent amount of grip. Alright, so for now, this thing is in first place. This is so far the best truck. So now, I'm gonna go back with the other GMC. And with this one, we got quite a lot of modification we can do. We can do stacks. Like here, we're gonna do it. Back racks. Fuel can. Little bacon right there. Toolbox. And oh, can I look more like a tow truck? I'm not trying to like that. I like that small one. So we got some TSL right now. And we can have some bugger. Can have some Thornbird. We can have some Maxis. What Mutasis? Or what the? What the hell is a tractor tire? So I'm gonna stick with the TSL slash could be IROC too. And alright, so far I love the detail of this truck. It's just it's amazingly detailed, and it's quiet. It's way too quiet. Oh, and lack a bit of power because I was not able to put in second gear right there. So I'm curious to see what's gonna be in the trail. And the big toolhook in the back is pretty nice addition. I think it's the first time I've seen it in Spit Tire. And then I should not have put the stacks. I forgot how annoying is this to ride with one. Just can't see shit when you're pulling. Alright. Yeah, this thing is really slow. The gears are super low. Let's jump in the mud. In my memory, that was way more deep. Alright, put this in first gear. See what we can do. Yeah, I can feel this thing is heavy. It's getting some grip though. Oh, Let's go, don't make me speak too fast. I said you have grip. So get up. I think I'm on the tree. No, I'm not. Just on the edge to get up, but really don't want to. Come on. And I was in the tree, but I made it. And gotta say, this truck is really smooth in comparison with the 1500 we just do. This thing is super smooth. Just flexes up thing, super smooth. No seems to want to bounce or anything. Look at that, super smooth landing. And the toe actually move. That is pretty cool. Yeah, we're gonna get stuck here. That's for sure. We're way too heavy. Holy damn! Did we just make it? The thing is amazing. I think does feel like it weighed twice as much as the other one. But just a little bit of rocking in the steering wheel and we're up. Definitely gonna use this truck more. I think it's the first time I use it to actually. Enough problem in the little rock section right there. Just positioning. Guys are gonna get got on the bumper. Some gear, sorry about that. Yeah, I can't see right there, but seems like the bumper giving me a little bit of problem. There we go. Oh, come on. Come on. No, don't flip over. Damn it. Was doing so well, but was really struggling up there. Can I get it back? I don't think. But I'm just too sad to let it sit there. I'm gonna grab the Chevy. It's a Chevy Tima. I'm just go on and rescue it. Thank you.
slide right there. That's gonna be good. And I'm gonna go back to that GMC. And finish the run. Because this thing is really just too fun to let it lay on its side. Because of my mistake. Thing is, I think it's like a bit too high, but has weird flex. Come on, the next section. Now we get a grip. So, the 97 did better because I didn't have to tow it actually, but I'm gonna give the win to this one because this one was just the most fun to drive, and I think it was the most capable because we have struggled so much with the 97. So the win gonna go to this one, the 99. So thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe if you like the video. See you in the next one. Peace out.